Now, I would like to invite Mr. Alexander Zaborsky to give his speech on French expertise in e-government.
Assalamu alaikum. It's a great pleasure for me to be here today. I would like to thank, of course, your university to invite me and also the ITA organization for organizing this event. And I would like also to thank Mr. Hadj for his invitation. Thank you for that. So we are going to talk. I'm going to tell you a story about a gnu, a penguin, and frogs. I'm going to talk about OpenGov and OpenEGov in France. So to start, why it is so important to understand what happens in my country is maybe because France today is very well ranked by the United Nations in terms of adoption of open source. We were ranked number 4 in terms of e-administration adoption by the United Nations 2 years ago, and we fell to the tenth place. But we are still very good and see like that in terms of adoption of open source. There is something specific happens in my country. So why French government has chosen to develop OpenEGov, not only eGov? First, because, and you have understood already that in Oman, and also what Brian and Chris already told this morning, so the future is open. Today, if you had to develop a new company such as Google, Facebook, any startup that you would like to develop, you will develop this new company with open source software. And when you decide to develop a new project, you develop new digital service. Today in the world, 90% of new digital services are built on open source software. But also because open source bring, with open source, you bring or you develop also all the open innovation. You know, this year in CES, Consumer Electronics Show in Las Vegas, the CEO of one of the main car manufacturers in the world, so the CEO Carlos Ghosn, went to this CES and he decided to communicate not about new functionalities for his cars, knew about connected cars, but he decided to introduce and to present to the world the new initiative done by Renault, which is a POM, a platform, open-minded platform, which is, you know, they have a car called Twizy, and they have decided to open all the Twizy cars. That is to say that they give all the specifications of this car, not only the electronic part, but also the mechanic part. And they make the bet that tomorrow, in all engineering school, people, they will learn about how making a connected car and an electronic car with this platform. And the bet that Renault has done is to have new engineers, researchers, they will work with them to develop this new generation of a car. And so when you are a CEO such as Carlos Ghosn, and you take the decision to communicate on that, it shows you the level today of attention from all the C-level, C-executive about open source software. But open source is also one of the ways you can develop your open data strategy, and what is why it is so important to have your own open data strategy is because open data, with open data, you develop a lot of external positive outcomes. You know, if you have data into your company and you don't use this data, the value of this data is nothing. But in putting your data into the open source landscape and to share your data with anyone, you allow either your employees or third-party companies to develop new services around your own companies and your own services from your company. And you create more value in opening your data than to keep the data for yourself. But also because the open source landscape, in the open source landscape, you have also all open API strategy that you can put in place and you can develop. And today, you have to think the way you develop your own IT system, not as, you know, a classical IT system, vertical, and that will not communicate with the exterior, with the other systems, but as a complete platform, and you will allow anyone to use and to consume not only the data you are providing, but also the services that you can provide with your own IT system. And one of the main ideas is to build a complete open platform. And today, one of the big issues around open source is not open source by itself, but the way you could and you could become an actor of the open source world as a contributor for open source software. And in the past, we have done a lot of strategic consulting service for large organizations. And one of our recommendations was to adopt an open first strategy. And today what we tell to our big customers, to the large organization, is to think the way they could become a great contributor to open source and to develop their own share first strategy. At the end of the day, one the main issue, as I mentioned, is to consider your IT system as a complete platform, as finally if you were a kind of Google or Facebook platform. And for example, you can be part as the retail market, as a retailer, or to be a bank, and to think tomorrow as a bank, oh, I'm going to be able to deliver not the banking services as I have always done, but to deliver new services, to attract new people into my own landscape, in my own ecosystem, and to develop with also third part new services to my customers. And for that, the best way to develop that is, of course, open source. And that's the same in government, of course. So what happens in France? So first, we have a favorable regulation. So not the last, but the one before, Prime Minister Jean-Marc Ayrault decided to make a public decision encouraging all the public administration to use open source software. But in that order, in that public order, it was not only to use open source software, but to be sure that every year, every administration, they will use more open source software. And for that, every year, to know what was done with open source software, and to take the strategic decision to move forward and quicker and to invest more in the open source. And because of that, you know, France is a democracy, but, you know, is a democracy with a strong central power. And because of that, you know, all the administration and even the public agencies So they have followed this instruction from the Prime Minister, and they have decided to move forward in using open source. With the Prime Minister office, they have decided to create what they called ETALab, which is the public agency dedicated to the governance of all IT systems from the government. And so ETALab was behind the open data strategy of France. They have also funded this initiative called ETA Platform, so government platform. They have developed also a unique identity solution called France Connect, to be able to be connected to the any French administration website with only one SSO, one single point of identity. And I have also done two very interesting initiatives. One is called Startup de l'État, so startup from the government. When you have a public servant who decides to develop a new service because he thinks in his administration something could be done better than it is done, so he can say that this is what we should do. It goes in front of a commission. He has an examination for that. And if he's able to decide the public decider from the ETALab, it will be financed to develop the new service. And so they built new startup in the state to deliver new services that address specific need from the point of view of public servants for the need of the citizens. And I have also developed, but that program also exists in the US, an initiative to have entrepreneur, freelancer, they move from the private sector to the public sector, and they have a short contract, and they are hired for a specific mission for that, and this is what they called entrepreneur d'intérêt général. But the French government is not only a user. As I told you, one of the main issues today is also to become a contributor, a developer of open source software, and the French gov decided to invest directly into open source. And they do that in two different ways. The first one is to finance private sector who propose to develop new open source software. And for example, with my company, we presented a project called OpenPass, which is a fully open platform solution. And this program that we work with some very high-level universities, such as School of Polytechnic in France. So this program, the government has given to us more than 10 million euros to develop this new OpenPass solution. But the second way is to have also public finance given to the public administration, and into this administration they've developed a new open source program. And for example, today you have this program called VITAM, which is the new legal archive system for the French government. It's been handled by one of the administration with the support of the private sector, of course, which work with this kind of, with these bodies, with this organization, but it's made by an administration for the other administration. And they have also launched two new programs around OpenStack. So the way they do that concretely in the French gov. First, what you have to know is today the French government runs for 50% of the public servant a free and open source solution, which is an open source email solution. And so they don't use anymore Microsoft Exchange or IBM solution, nor for the moment Gmail. And so 50% in terms of the market share in the French gov is done with our solution called OBM. And we have this, the same kind of success in some countries such as Tunisia, for example, or in Africa, or in Quebec. And that's something that we could do, of course, with Oman government. Also, a large part of the French gov doesn't use, you know, any system such as Dropbox or file transfer or things like that. They use a solution called LinShare. LinShare, which is a kind of Dropbox, but fully open source, is a free and open source solution that we have specifically developed for the French government. And today, for example, the finance ministry or the interior ministry, the police ministry, they use this solution to share secure file in secure way. It's, of course, fully encrypted. You can have digital signature and so on. For that, the French gov and to support this open source strategy, the French gov has also put in place two major contracts for having support and maintenance for more than today 400 open source software. So we deliver that with an offer called OSSA, Open Source Software Assurance, and today we are the main provider for the French government for all their needs in terms of support and maintenance. That's a thing that any large organization, and especially government, they need to have if they want to develop concrete and real and large strategic plan of using open source. And through that, we deliver services with strong engagement. And we deliver services under SLA. And so if you have any problems with an open source software, under 4 hours, you can be supported by us. One of the things we think is really important is to consider the way we could deliver what we call the third digital way. Actually, when you are a large organization or when you are a government, the main choices that you have is either to use an American solution provided by one of the giants on the market. More and more often today, you have the Chinese offer, and the Chinese, they come not only with solution, but also with all the finance to finance the solution. Which is also funny is that most of the Chinese offer is based on open source software, by the way. And all the Chinese champions have strongly used open source software to develop their own digital services. Alibaba, Tencent, with all their solutions. They are one of the great users of open source. And so today you are balanced between these two large offers, Chinese and American offer. And what we strongly believe in France, and not only in France, in Europe, is that exists a third digital way based on collaboration, co-development, co-innovation, and that's something that we concretely do with Tunisia, with Morocco, with Algeria, with a lot of big countries in Africa. And that's something that we should consider to do also with GCC countries, and especially here in Oman, according to what I saw this morning, that the perfect, you know, mix between what France and Europe can bring to Oman and what you want to do here in Oman. Because at the end of the day, the main issue for countries is about digital sovereignty. And the decision we take today, the consequences will be within 10 or 20 years. And I'm sure that the future is only what we want it will be. So our future depends just on us. And so we are able to share these experiences, and we want to share these experiences with you. You know, France is the president of the Open Government Partnership Program, what was funded by the US and the Obama administration. I'm not sure that the Trump administration is really aligned with the goal of the Open Government Partnership. We will see. We have also funded an alliance called Alliance for Digital and Development. We have now 16 countries inside this alliance, so the ADD, and we work with all the countries they want for sharing experiences, return of experience, and share codes, and try to do a common project. It's not open to the government and the public agency, it's also open to the private sector. So if you are a system integrator, please do not hesitate to contact me and to consider the way we could work together. And we have also some very specific bilateral relationship in digital sector. I'm the one in charge of the this specific relationship between Tunisia and France, and it's an official responsibility given to me by my government. And we could maybe consider the same thing with the government of Oman. To finish, just a quick overview about what we do. I'm not going to give you all the details, but I wanted to tell you that my company is one of the oldest companies in the open source landscape. We are strongly present not only in Tunisia, where we have 50 people. So we have 50 people, they speak Arabic as their modern tongue. So we can very easily work between Oman and Linagora. So that's all. Our future is open. Just develop it together. Thank you so much.